Everybody, I'm Dick Button, and I'm right outside the Scandaria Ice Rink, where the event that everybody has been waiting for has begun. That's the ladies' competition in the figure skating championship. Who is going to win the gold medal in ladies' figure skating here at the Sarajevo Winter Games? Well, the competition started this morning with the compulsory figures, and the American team was all here. Now, they're a lovely bunch of young ladies, but each one totally different from the other. And the question is, how did they do and how did they fare in the compulsory figures, which require a very special type of temperament? The figures are exacting, demanding. They require nerves, control, and serious concentration. You cannot let up for 1 second in those school figures. So how did our American girls, each of whom is totally different from the other, fare in the compulsory figures? Well, in order to understand how they did in the compulsory figures, you have to understand what makes each girl tick and how they got to be here at the Olympic Games in the first place. In 1981, for example, Rosalind Sumners was only able to manage a fifth-place win in the U.S. National Figure Skating Championships. But in 1982, when she won the competition, everyone was kind of surprised, but not Rosalind. You see, she had a quiet confidence that masked a cool determination and a very strong will to win. So when she mounted that stand, it may have been surprising to other people in the audience, but it was not to Rosalind. And then in 1983, she won her second United States figure skating title, and then promptly proceeded to go on to Finland, to Helsinki, where she won the 1983 World Championship. She proved to everyone, and most of all to herself, that she was no fluke. And at the same time, she gave further impetus to her growing reputation as the Grace Kelly of the ice. Blonde, aristocratic, reserved, capable, and very pretty. But 1984 was not to be so easy. She won the national championships all right, but it was less than a first-class performance. Despite this fall and other minor mishaps, Rosalind did not choke. She kept her cool. She remained the poised champion right to the very end. And thus we can understand what appears to be her greatest asset, her ability to concentrate and to focus on the job that's right at hand. And it was that very quality which she needed a great deal of this morning when she started the compulsory figures at the Scandaria Ice Rink. This was the first figure, a forward inside rocker. Look at the attention to detail, the steadiness of the edges, the tracing of the lines, how clean and smooth she is as she steps into this back inside edge. She was second in this, the first figure, and off to a very good start. Now, they say on Broadway that you can become a success overnight after many years of hard work. Well, young Tiffany Chin, our number two yet lady, has emerged on the scene as a force to reckon with, and it appears to be just overnight. We first met her in 1983 when she vaulted from fifth to third at our national championships. But she really made her mark just a month ago in Salt Lake at this year's national championship when she won both the long and the short free skating programs and won the silver medal overall. She finally emerged from behind Elaine Zayach's shadow. And now Tiffany is eager to show her potential and to be taken seriously. Here at practice a few days ago, we saw her stretching out, moving easily and smoothly across the ice. You see, even though she's a tough competitor, she's approaching this Olympics as an opportunity for everyone to see how well she can skate and with what potential she will be a future champion. Jim McKay will tell us more about her.
Chinese man, drawing the characters Chen Ting Ting. That's his granddaughter's name in his native language. The skating world knows his granddaughter as Tiffany Chin, a growing presence on the world scene at age 16. They call her the China doll, 5 feet tall and 90 pounds, and when she chooses to, she can look very much like a porcelain figure who should be poised atop a music box. But she's more than that. At age 13, she became the first skater of an Oriental background to win a world championship, the world junior title. At 16, she seems poised for a big move forward. She made the American team for last year's world championships and finished a very respectable ninth.
Like other working people in Southern California, she had to battle the freeway for 2 or 3 hours a day to train with her coach, John Nick.
And then you're out there. Move.
A lot of people now call her the China doll, and it's a fact that she's a doll-like in appearance sometimes. She's quite a small young lady, compact. As you know, China dolls are pretty fragile, and Tiffany is not. She has a great inner strength and fortitude.
That's right.
Tiffany's the youngest member of the American World Team and the only one who attends a regular high school.
I'm taking 3 classes, English, history, and algebra. I go just half day, but then I have to make up the rest of it in the summer, so I'm in school all year round. Sometimes I feel that I have to always be perfect, but when I think about it, my second thoughts are, no, that's not true, Tiffany. It's just that you're putting the pressure on yourself, because you don't have to be that way. Just let loose and be yourself. And that usually works. Then I don't have to be perfect anymore. I think that with all this going on, I feel confident knowing that my family is 100% behind me. My mom and my coach, I think, are my greatest assets. They guide me and steer me, hopefully, in the right direction.
In traditional Chinese fashion, Tiffany is closely supported by her family. Her mother, Marjorie, her father, Edward, her 7-year-old little brother, Michael, 14-year-old sister, Tammy, and her grandparents from mainland China. She likes being Chinese-American.
I don't think my Chinese background has affected me at all. In fact, it's maybe helped me. When I'm out there skating, they'll maybe think, oh, there's that Chinese little girl. And maybe I stand out a little more. And I'm not ashamed at all. I'm very proud to be Chinese.
Tiffany Chin. A China doll with a core of spring steel, hoping for gold, silver, or bronze in Sarajevo.
With her strong family background and strength of character, Tiffany Chin may well be on her way to the top of the figure skating world. But right now, that seems to lie in the future. What she really needs at this point is experience, exposure, and seasoning. And as we see her perform the second figure here, the paragraph 3, you can see the steadiness that she already shows and the composure that she has. Look at the threes here. The smooth back inside edge. And again, the turning 3. She was only 13th going into this figure, and pulled up to 12th after it. The expectation is that she'll move up considerably higher after the free skating.